Geyser, Wikipedia audio. A geyser is a spring characterized by intermittent discharge of water ejected turbulently and accompanied by steam. As a fairly rare phenomenon, the formation of geysers is due to particular hydrogeological conditions that exist only in a few places on Earth. Generally, all geyser field sites are located near active volcanic areas, and the geyser effect is due to the proximity of magma. Generally, surface water works its way down to an average depth of around 2,000 meters where it contacts hot rocks. The resultant boiling of the pressurized water results in the geyser effect of hot water and steam spraying out of the geyser's surface vent. At least 1,283 geysers have erupted in Yellowstone National Park, Wyoming, United States, and an average of 465 geysers are active there in a given year. A geyser's eruptive activity may change or cease due to ongoing mineral deposition within the geyser plumbing, exchange of functions with nearby hot springs, earthquake influences, and human intervention. Form and function. Like many other natural phenomena, geysers are not unique to planet Earth. Jet-like eruptions, often referred to as cryogeysers, have been observed on several of the moons of the outer solar system. Due to the low ambient pressures, these eruptions consist of vapor without liquid. They are made more easily visible by particles of dust and ice carried aloft by the gas. Water vapor jets have been observed near the south pole of Saturn's moon Enceladus, while nitrogen eruptions have been observed on Neptune's moon Triton. There are also signs of carbon dioxide eruptions from the southern polar ice cap of Mars. In the latter two cases, instead of being driven by geothermal energy, the eruptions seem to rely on solar heating via a solid-state greenhouse effect. Geysers are temporary geological features. Geysers are generally associated with volcanic areas. As the water boils, the resulting pressure forces a superheated column of steam and water to the surface through the geyser's internal plumbing. The formation of geysers specifically requires the combination of three geologic conditions that are usually found in volcanic terrain. Enceladus. Geyser activity, like all hot spring activity, is caused by surface water gradually seeping down through the ground until it meets rock heated by magma. The geothermally heated water then rises back toward the surface by convection through porous and fractured rocks. Geysers differ from non-eruptive hot springs in their subterranean structure. Many consist of a small vent at the surface connected to one or more narrow tubes that lead to underground reservoirs of water and pressure-tight rock. As the geyser fills, the water at the top of the column cools off. But because of the narrowness of the channel, convective cooling of the water in the reservoir is impossible. The cooler water above presses down on the hotter water beneath, not unlike the lid of a pressure cooker, allowing the water in the reservoir to become superheated, i.e. to remain liquid at temperatures well above the standard pressure boiling point. Ultimately, the temperatures near the bottom of the geyser rise to a point where boiling begins, which forces steam bubbles to rise to the top of the column. As they burst through the geyser's vent, some water overflows or splashes out, reducing the weight of the column and thus the pressure on the water below. With this release of pressure, the superheated water flashes into steam, boiling violently throughout the column. The resulting froth of expanding steam and hot water then sprays out of the geyser vent. A key requirement that enables a geyser to erupt is a material called geyserite found in rocks nearby the geyser. Geyserite, mostly silicon dioxide, is dissolved from the rocks and gets deposited on the walls of the geyser's plumbing system and on the surface. The deposits make the channels carrying the water up to the surface pressure tight. This allows the pressure to be carried all the way to the top and not be leaked out into the loose gravel or soil that are normally under the geyser fields. Eventually, the water remaining in the geyser cools back to below the boiling point and the eruption ends. Heated groundwater begins seeping back into the reservoir, and the whole cycle begins again. The duration of eruptions and time between successive eruptions vary greatly from geyser to geyser. Strokkr in Iceland erupts for a few seconds every few minutes, while Grand Geyser in the United States erupts for up to 10 minutes every 8-12 hours. There are two types of geysers: fountain geysers, which erupt from pools of water, typically in a series of intense, even violent, bursts, and cone geysers, which erupt from cones or mounds of siliceous sinter, usually in steady jets that last anywhere from a few seconds to several minutes. Old Faithful, perhaps the best-known geyser at Yellowstone National Park, is an example of a cone geyser. Grand Geyser, the tallest predictable geyser on Earth, also at Yellowstone National Park, is an example of a fountain geyser. There are many volcanic areas in the world that have hot springs, mud pots and fumaroles, but very few have erupting geysers. The main reason for their rarity is because multiple intense transient forces must occur simultaneously for a geyser to exist. For example, even when other necessary conditions exist, if the rock structure is loose, eruptions will erode the channels and rapidly destroy any nascent geysers. Intense heat. As a result, most geysers form in places where there is volcanic rhyolite rock, which dissolves in hot water and forms mineral deposits called siliceous sinter, or geyserite, along the inside of the plumbing systems, which are very slender. Over time, these deposits strengthen the channel walls by cementing the rock together tightly, thus enabling the geyser to persist, as mentioned in the previous section. Geysers are fragile phenomena, and if conditions change, they may go dormant or extinct. Many have been destroyed simply by people throwing debris into them, while others have ceased to erupt due to dewatering by geothermal power plants. However, the Great Geyser of Iceland has had periods of activity and dormancy. During its long dormant periods, eruptions were sometimes artificially induced, often on special occasions by the addition of surfactants to the water. The specific colors of geysers derive from the fact that despite the apparently harsh conditions, life is often found in them in the form of thermophilic prokaryotes. No known eukaryote can survive over 60 degrees Celsius. In the 1960s, when the research of biology of geysers first appeared, scientists were generally convinced that no life can survive above around 73 degrees Celsius maximum, the upper limit for the survival of cyanobacteria, as the structure of key cellular proteins and deoxyribonucleic acid would be destroyed. The optimal temperature for thermophilic bacteria was placed even lower, around 55 degrees Celsius average. However, the observations proved that it is actually possible for life to exist at high temperatures, and that some bacteria even prefer temperatures higher than the boiling point of water. Dozens of such bacteria are known. Thermophiles prefer temperatures from 50 to 70 degrees Celsius, whilst hyperthermophiles grow better at temperatures as high as 80 to 110 degrees Celsius. As they have heat-stable enzymes that retain their activity even at high temperatures, they have been used as a source of thermostable tools that are important in medicine and biotechnology, for example in manufacturing antibiotics, plastics, detergents, and fermentation products. Among these, the first discovered and the most important for biotechnology is Thermus aquaticus. The fact that such bacteria exist also stretches our imagination about life on other celestial bodies, both within and beyond the solar system. Geysers are quite rare, requiring a combination of water, heat, and fortuitous plumbing. The combination exists in few places on Earth. Yellowstone is the largest geyser locale, containing thousands of hot springs, and approximately 300 to 500 geysers. It is home to half of the world's total number of geysers in its 9 geyser basins. It is located mostly in Wyoming, USA, with small portions in Montana and Idaho. Yellowstone includes the world's tallest active geyser, as well as the renowned Old Faithful Geyser, Beehive Geyser, Giantess Geyser, Lion Geyser, Plume Geyser, Orem Geyser, Castle Geyser, Sawmill Geyser, Grand Geyser, Oblong Geyser, Giant Geyser, Daisy Geyser, Grotto Geyser, the Fan and Mortar Geysers, and the Riverside Geyser, all in the Upper Geyser Basin, which alone contains nearly 180 geysers. Water. A plumbing system. The Valley of Geysers, located in the Kamchatka Peninsula of Russia, is the only geyser field in Eurasia and the second largest concentration of geysers in the world. The area was discovered and explored by Tatyana Ustinova in 1941. Approximately 200 geysers exist in the area, along with many hot water springs and perpetual spouters. The area was formed due to a vigorous volcanic activity. The peculiar way of eruptions is an important feature of these geysers. Most of the geysers erupt at angles, and only very few have the geyser cones that exist at many other of the world's geyser fields. On June 3, 2007, a massive mudflow influenced two-thirds of the valley. It was then reported that a thermal lake was forming above the valley. Few days later, waters were observed to have receded somewhat, exposing some of the submerged features. Velikan Geyser, one of the field's largest, was not buried in the slide and has recently been observed to be active. Eruptions. General categorization. Biology. Major geyser fields and their distribution. Yellowstone National Park, U.S. The name El Tashio comes from the Quechua word for oven. El Tashio is located in the high valleys on the Andes, surrounded by many active volcanoes in Chile, South America, at around 4,200 meters above mean sea level. The valley is home to approximately 80 geysers at present. It became the largest geyser field in the southern hemisphere after the destruction of many of the New Zealand geysers, and is the third largest geyser field in the world. The salient feature of these geysers is that the height of their eruptions is very low, the tallest being only 6 meters high, but with steam columns that can be over 20 meters high. The average geyser eruption height at El Tashio is about 750 millimeters. The Taupo Volcanic Zone is located on New Zealand's North Island. It is 350 kilometers long by 50 kilometers wide and lies over a subduction zone in the Earth's crust. Mount Ruapehu marks its southwestern end, while the submarine Wakatan volcano is considered its northeastern limit. Many geysers in this zone were destroyed due to geothermal developments in a hydroelectric reservoir, but several dozen geysers still exist. In the beginning of the 20th century, the largest geyser ever known, the Waimangu Geyser, existed in this zone. It began erupting in 1900 and erupted periodically for 4 years until a landslide changed the local water table. Eruptions of Wayang would typically reach 160 meters and some superbursts are known to have reached 500 meters. Recent scientific work indicates that the Earth's crust below the zone may be as little as 5 kilometers thick. Beneath this lies a film of magma 50 kilometers wide and 160 kilometers long. Due to the high rate of volcanic activity in Iceland, it is home to some famous geysers in the world. Geysers and hot springs are distributed all over the island. Many of the geysers are located in Haukadalur. Geysers are known to have existed in at least a dozen other areas on the island. The Great Geyser, which first erupted in the 14th century, gave rise to the word geyser. By 1896, Geyser was almost dormant before an earthquake that year caused eruptions to begin again, occurring several times a day, but in 1916, eruptions all but ceased. Throughout much of the 20th century, eruptions, usually following earthquakes, did happen from time to time. Some man-made improvements were made to the spring and eruptions were forced with soap on special occasions. Earthquakes in June 2000 subsequently reawakened the giant for a time, but it is not currently erupting regularly. The nearby Strokkr geyser erupts every 5-8 minutes to a height of some 30 meters. Valley of Geysers, Russia. There used to be two large geysers fields in Nevada, Biawa and Steamboat Springs, but they were destroyed by the installation of nearby geothermal power plants. At the plants, geothermal drilling reduced the available heat and lowered the local water table to the point that geyser activity could no longer be sustained. Many of New Zealand's geysers have been destroyed by humans in the last century. Several New Zealand geysers have also become dormant or extinct by natural means. The main remaining field is Wakarewa at Rotorua. Two-thirds of the geysers at Orakei Koroko were flooded by the Ahakuri hydroelectric dam in 1961. The Wairakei field was lost to a geothermal power plant in 1958. The Taupo Spa field was lost when the Waikato River level was deliberately altered in the 1950s. The Rotomehana field was destroyed by the Mount Tararua eruption in 1886. There are various other types of geysers which are different in nature compared to the normal steam-driven geysers. These geysers differ not only in their style of eruption but also in the cause that makes them erupt. In a number of places where there is geothermal activity, wells have been drilled and fitted with impermeable casements that allow them to erupt like geysers. The vents of such geysers are artificial, but are tapped into natural hydrothermal systems. These so-called artificial geysers, technically known as erupting geothermal wells, are not true geysers. Little Old Faithful Geyser, in Calistoga, California, is an example. The geyser erupts from the casing of a well drilled in the late 19th century. According to Dr. John Reinhardt in his book A Guide to Geyser Gazing, a man had drilled into the geyser in search for water. He had simply opened up a dead geyser. This is a natural hot spring that spouts water constantly without stopping for recharge. Some of these are incorrectly called geysers, but because they are not periodic in nature, they are not considered true geysers. Geysers are used for various activities such as electricity generation, heating, and tourism. Many geothermal reserves are found all around the world. The geyser fields in Iceland are some of the most commercially viable geyser locations in the world. Since the 1920s, hot water directed from the geysers has been used to heat greenhouses and to grow food that otherwise could not have been cultivated in Iceland's inhospitable climate. Steam and hot water from the geysers has also been used for heating homes since 1943 in Iceland. In 1979, the U.S. Department of Energy actively promoted development of geothermal energy in the Geysers Calistoga Known Geothermal Resource Area near Calistoga, California through a variety of research programs and the Geothermal Loan Guarantee Program. The department is obligated by law to assess the potential environmental impacts of geothermal development. There are several bodies in the solar system where jet-like eruptions, often termed cryogeysers, have been observed or are believed to occur. Unlike geysers on Earth, these represent eruptions of volatiles, together with entrained dust or ice particles, without liquid. El Tashio, Chile. Taupo Volcanic Zone, New Zealand. Iceland. Extinct and dormant geyser fields. Misnamed geysers. Artificial geysers. Perpetual sputter. Commercialization. Cryogeysers. Notes.